Hello there, and thank you very much for joining us in this new Azure Portal how-to video. Today, we will learn how to use the new storage browser. And we have Misha Dar back with us to show us how to use it. So thank you very much for joining us again, Misha.
Thank you so much for having me back, Leon. It's so good to be here again. In previous videos, we created a brand new storage account and then walked through how to manage it. Today, why don't we look at how we can work with the data in the storage account using this brand new storage browser?
That sounds awesome. Let's see it.
Let's go. First, we need to find the storage account we wish to work with. If you're looking to find a full list of storage accounts in your subscriptions, navigate to storage accounts in the portal and choose the desired account. Since we've been working with this account recently, you can see it under recent resources. We're going to click here to jump right in. We're back on the overview page, and the entry point to the storage browser is here on the left, right at the top. Let's click on it. Here, we can see key metrics for each of the different sub-resources within the storage account: blobs, files, tables, and queues. These metrics here refresh a couple times a day, so please don't expect it to immediately reflect changes that you make to the data in your account. Since we don't have any data yet in the storage account, these fields are blank. At the top, we provide you a way to delete or export any favorites or recently used metadata. On the left, you can see a list of favorites, recently viewed items, and entry points to each of the four sub-resources. Feel free to click on any one of them to jump in. At the bottom of the page, we provide you with another entry point to the Desktop Storage Explorer app. If you're looking to manage your account at scale or multiple accounts at once, without having to connect to the portal, the desktop client is a great tool. So let's take a look at our container service here. Clicking into Blob Containers, we are presented with a list of containers for the Blob service. In Azure, every blob must be stored within a parent container. So before you can upload any blobs, you need to create a container first. Let's do that right now. You specify a name. Something simple will do. We click Create. And there we go. So clicking into the container, we now have a clean slate with which we can operate. Let's upload a couple of files from our local machine. As you can see, we now have drag and drop functionality in addition to using a file browser. I can select a couple of files and drag them over. We can choose to overwrite files if they already exist, but since we don't have any files yet, we can just click Upload, and there we go. All those files are now in this account, saved as blobs. Now that we have these blobs in our container and in our storage account, there are a lot of things that we can do with them. We can change the sorting order in this grid. And of course, since they were all uploaded at the same time, the last modified time is all the same for them. But if you have blobs modified at different times, you can do that. You can select a couple of items or all of them. We can delete blobs, you can download them. You can even copy and paste them into another container if you want to move them around. If you want to see more about an individual blob, we can click into it to inspect it further. Here you can see key properties for the blob. You can view previous versions and snapshots, and you can even view and edit some blobs depending on the file format. If you're looking to reduce the cost of storing a blob that isn't accessed or modified regularly, you can change the access tier to cooler archive. And so that's a quick overview of the blob service. Let's take a look at the file service. Popping back up and clicking over to file shares, it's actually a very similar experience. Just like you need a container for your blobs, you need a file share for your files. So let's add one right now. The transaction optimized here will provide a great mix of performance and affordability for most scenarios. A quick refresh, and we should see the file share in this list here. There it is. unlike Blob Storage, a lot of people don't use the portal to manage the data in their file shares. Rather, they connect to this file share from a different machine, where they mount the file share as a drive. We tried to provide some guidance on how to do this for your file shares. Select the file share that you want to connect to, and then click the Connect button in the command bar at the top. We provide instructions for Windows, Linux, and macOS. Follow the instructions and you should have no problem connecting to your file share. However, if you do wish to manage the data in your file share in the portal, you can do that too. Let's click into the file share and take a look. Similar to the Blob service, we provide drag and drop upload capabilities for files as well. So let's bring a couple more in and upload. And now anyone connected to your file share will now be able to access these files. You can delete, copy, and paste just like you did with Blobs as well. We have similar creation and management experiences for queues and messages, as well as tables and entities. In the interest of time today, we won't dive into these specifically. A couple of other items before we wrap up today. At the beginning, we talked about recently viewed and favorites over here on the left, and we can view both easily. To add to your list of favorites, hover over a container, file share, queue, or table, and click the star. Once you click it, you'll see it pinned above, underneath the favorites header. This favorite will persist across your portal sessions as long as you're logged in with the same Azure credentials. To remove a favorite, unclick the star icon. You can have up to 5 objects pinned to your favorite menu at any time.
Thank you very much, Misha. This was great. I learned a lot and I hope you learned a lot too. Please try this out. Let us know what you think. Leave us a comment in the comment section. And one thing to mention, this was the last part of a 3-part series. Misha came 3 times to show us first how to create a storage account, then how to manage that storage account, and finally how to put data on that storage account. So please watch the 3 of them. Let us know what you think. I hope that you enjoy them and look forward to seeing you in the next video. Bye for now.